watching an area down in the Caribbean. It hasn't developed that close center of circulation, so it's not officially a tropical system yet, but we expect it to become one, and that could happen as early as today. So we're going to monitor it, of course, over the next several days. This is the area that we're tracking, that area of low pressure. It's moving to the north at 7 miles per hour, and the National Hurricane Center is already issuing advisories on this to kind of get ahead of it. So even though it's not a tropical system, because we expect it to become one, that's why we have that forecast cone. So tropical storm Rafael likely as early as today with winds near 40 miles per hour. Now, this part of the Atlantic Basin over the northern and western Caribbean is pretty conducive for tropical development. So that's why you see it strengthening into a Category 1 hurricane Tuesday night into Wednesday. Now, there will be some land interaction. Remember, land helps to disrupt these systems and sometimes, a lot of times, could help to weaken it, but it's also a very narrow strip of land over western Cuba. Right now, the forecast calls for a hurricane, a Category 1 hurricane, to be in the southern or southeastern Gulf of Mexico as we get into Wednesday night and early Thursday. I also want to mention, too, that, you know, a lot of times with systems that have not developed yet or are rather weak, there can be more margin for error with a forecast track, but it's good to see that the model consensus keeps us to the west of southwest Florida. We'll watch for any kind of shifts, but right now it looks like this could potentially stay here several hundred miles to the west of our coastline, but close enough to at least bring us some peripheral effects, some side effects, the main thing being some rain and some breezier conditions. So here's your updated forecast model as we take a look at this into Wednesday early in the morning. So again, this is after Election Day, into Wednesday afternoon. You'll notice that circulation over western Cuba. And then it continues that northwesterly track. I want you to see how some of this tropical moisture does make it into southwest Florida. So we're expecting to see some periods of rain, even some thunderstorms possible. And inside of some of those cells, we could see some higher wind gusts up closer to perhaps 30, 35, 40 miles per hour. So it looks like Wednesday into Thursday is when it will make its closest pass to our area. And then by Thursday night, start to move away from us. And the wind shear is really going to have an effect and take a toll on the storm. So this is not going to be another Milton-type event. So tracking the tropics, here's what to know. Rafael expected to stay west of southwest Florida. There could be some shifts in the track, so just make sure to stay updated. But it'll be close enough either way to bring some rain and also some gusty winds. And we'll start to see that Wednesday into Thursday. That's the timing based on the current forecast track with this storm. We're not expecting to see a whole lot of rain with this. I think for most of us, about a half an inch to an inch, we could see a few spots get up over an inch of rainfall. But some of that rain mixed with some of the residual salt spray from Milton, that's one of the reasons why we've had those power outages, could lead to some more power outages throughout the course of this week. So we'll be watching for that.